Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti UniFi Mobile Router, the UMR. It's a slight change for what we've seen for some of the mobile routers that Ubiquiti have done so far. We've had the LTE Pro, which was more of a failover or a device that would work with something like the UDM SE or the UDM Pro. And now we're seeing more this trend towards the Internet of Things, IoT, and mobile routers. So let me show you what you're going to get in the box. Not going to be a big technical overview, but we'll help you understand a few bits. You will get a beautiful tiny QR code. There we go. And a little picture there of your router on the back. That's about all you're going to get. And you're going to get your little conformity guide that will probably, I expect, never come out of the plastic wrap. You will get a packet of screws and lugs and a SIM release tool there. You will get a power pack. All right, this is European. Whether we're going to see a Australian version of this, I'm not totally sure. We probably will do. It is about a couple of meter cable, but it is a standard USB-C input there, as you can see. Just show you that at the moment, but that's the European plug on there. You are going to get the antennas, which I'll show you how those fit together in a moment. All right, they have got some small antenna connections there on the bottom. You are going to get, so this is DIN rail mountable, so we've got our little mount there for the wall. You then get a backing plate for it. Now there are, I'll show you in a minute, there are a couple of other clips as well. Here's the router, which I'll show you how it fits together in a moment. But the idea being that this is going to clip into the back of your mount. If you wanted to DIN rail mount this, you're gonna take your rail here, mount it on the wall, clip this into place, pull that down, and now that's gonna be mounted on the wall if you wanted to do it, or you've got a DIN rail or something like that already in place. So let me just show you those fittings. You're just going to get the little rail mount there. I'll hold up the right way for you. And let me just take this off here. And you are going to get the release bracket. What you do get is this little piece. We've seen these on, so like the USW Lite 8 and the Flex Mini. So you do actually get a couple of these in the pack as well. Hopefully you can see those fairly small. The idea being, again, you're going to screw that to the wall if you want to and bring your device up, flick it into place there, and that's going to be flush mounted against the wall like that. So you do have a couple of mounting options to make that worthwhile. So like I said, here is the unit itself. We've got a small LCD screen here that's going to give you some of the information about how it is running. On the back here, not really much to see, other than I'm not sure whether you'll be able to see the little slot that I was talking about in there that allows us to bring our mounting bracket in and hold that in place. All right, then on the top, let's just have a little look. We have got our antenna in and we've got our SIM slot. And so then, like I said, we already had our antenna. The antenna we offer up onto the top like this and it clips into place. You'll see that we've got the release button on the back. And we can obviously bring those antennas out to give us the best connection that we want. So that is the outside of our unit. Let me just hold that up so you can maybe see that a little bit better. Then on the bottom. All right, so here we go. We have got our USB-C power in. So this will be USB powered if you want to use the power pack. We've got our little reset hole above that. You will then notice we have got, I'll just check we've got this the right way. We've got PoE in. So this is 48 volts PoE plus. So if you want to now PoE power this, you could do that. So you don't have to use the power pack. We could power this from our UDM SE or something else along those lines. All right, and we do have a PoE out port here. So as long as we put PoE plus in here, we can get, I believe, up to 10 watts of power on this. So if we are maybe wanting to set up run it out to another access point a little bit further away, then it will give us something fairly useful. Now this already does wireless, so this is not only just a 4G router, but it also does wireless. That PoE out is maybe going to be used for something else. Maybe you could even use that and plug in maybe a 48 volt Air Max product, so like the Nano Station 5 AC, the NS5 AC that does support 48 volts, and then you could run that out to a point-to-point link. You could think of the options. There's quite a few that you might have, or VoIP phone, could be quite a few options on there. You also have a DC power block option here as well. You don't have any cables in the box to do that, but that is an option. So, two one gig ports. This is going to do 4G or LTE. It's only rated up to about 150 meg a second with a 50 meg upload, so do be aware of that. This does support wireless. It only supports it in the B, G, and N. All right, we've got no wireless 6 and we've got no AC wireless standard. And this is not a 5 gigahertz wireless router. It only runs in the 2.4. What are we seeing? We're seeing really this geared towards the Internet of Things. This is going to go into your device, into a property, where you want some reporting, maybe from smart light bulbs, maybe from other reporting devices, maybe just some very basic wireless. You can use this to give you the Wi-Fi that you need over a 4G connection, but we're not looking for fast throughput, and therefore why do we necessarily need 5 gigahertz? Because really with 2.4 we're getting slightly better distance. And why do we need faster speed if we can max out only at 150 meg a second? I wanted to be clear on this. This here in Australia is SIM unlocked, all right? So any provider will work in here. But I also want you to be aware of the fact that this is designed to be run, if you want to manage multiple of these, I believe that Ubiquiti are going to have a mobile management portal where you can log these in and manage them globally. I presume it will be very much similar how you see the UDM SE and the UDM Pro. But at the moment, as long as you've got the UniFi app and you're connected to the wireless of this device, it might be I haven't tested it on the LAN as well, then you can actually manage this device using the UniFi app locally. I'm sure there's plenty of ways you can work around maybe trying to get this to call home and a few other bits and pieces, but I just want you to know about some of the limitations or where Ubiquiti is potentially going with this. So hopefully that's been useful. This is an Internet of Things router. It does 2.4 gigahertz of Wi-Fi. It does LTE, 3G and I think 4G. It supports about 150 meg a second down and about 50 meg a second up, powered by USB-C that we've talked about here, or PoE, and can give you up to 10 watts of PoE out. So many uses for this. It's a good price product, simple router, so it might be useful. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more unboxings, box openings even, on wireless network and firewall devices, how to set up UniFi Protect, how to set up UniFi Network, how to get the best out of your Ubiquiti products. So do subscribe and stay up to date.